Key Largo was literally put on the map thanks to the 1948 film of the same name. So where else would you hold the first annual Humphrey Bogart Film Festival? In Key Largo, of course. The city pulled out all the stops in order to make the event a success, including meet and greets with Bogart's son, Stephen, and rides on the African Queen. If you couldn't make it to last year's event, this is what you missed.
First off, Humphrey Bogart had the good fortune to be in more than a handful of really great movies. You know, there's some wonderful actors who I love and old movie buffs care about, but they don't have the reputations nowadays because the films haven't held up or the films aren't as well known. Bogart is, I think, very contemporary for a lot of reasons, but he played anti-heroes. He didn't play pretty boys. He played men with inner conflicts and who questioned things. And that's a very fresh kind of idea that still appeals to people today. The character of Rick in Casablanca is anything but a conventional Hollywood hero.
My sister and I have been thinking about something like this for a number of years. Now is the right time, and Key Largo was jumped right in. They threw everything they had at it. They were behind it 100%.
Thanks, everybody. I'm just so happy to be here in Key Largo, and I'm so happy that all you guys are here, and you're so enthusiastic and so nice, and I know that you're going to enjoy the movie.
10 of my father's movies, 10 other movies, everything from Double Indemnity and Chinatown and Sunset Boulevard to Drive, which is the Ryan Gosling movie. It's a noir festival, and so all the movies are going to be based on that. A lot of different films, Treasure of the Sierra Madre, African Queen. There's a lot of stuff. There's a Casablanca ball. Jack Huston's going to be down here accepting the Maltese Falcon Award on behalf of his grandfather. Where else? You know, you're not going to go to Africa. We could do the African Queen. But it was perfect. It's a name that's well known. It's a name that people identify with. They made the song, and it was one of my mother and father's finest films. Huston, Eddie Robinson, and you know, it was the perfect place to do it.
The town is named Key Largo because of the movie. They actually changed the name to Key Largo because it resonated so strongly from the 1948 movie that Bogart was in. And secondly, the African Queen is docked here. The co-star, you could say, of his wonderful movie with Katharine Hepburn. So there are two very strong, very real links to Bogart sitting right in front of us.
Well, people ask me that. I think either Key Largo or To Have and Have Not, because without To Have and Have Not, I would not be here. So I kind of like that one as well.
Director Howard Hawks caught lightning in a bottle when he discovered Lauren Bacall and cast her opposite Bogart in To Have and Have Not. And you just can't invent it. You can't create it. It's either there or it isn't there, and it was there. Well, my favorite film of all is Casablanca, which I saw during a Bogart revival in the late 60s. At that time, he was sort of rediscovered by a new generation. And I was one of the lucky ones who got to see that film for the first time in a movie theater. Not on TV, not on some form of home video, which came later, but in a theater on a big screen in the dark, the way it should be seen at its best.
I hope it happens. I hope it happens every year, and I hope everybody comes down and has a good time. That everybody's happy with how it comes out. That's really all you can ask for the first one.
Last year's festival even featured a guest appearance with actor Jack Huston, son of Key Largo director John Huston. To learn more about this event, log on to BogartFilmFestival.com.